Welcome back, everybody, here to your international qualifying coverage, day number four, and the loser bracket. First final for Dustbin versus World Elite. They must win to stay here in the competition. That's right, Dustbin are currently one game down. World Elite very convincingly going through the last game. Let's jump ourselves into the next game while it's already started off. But yeah, World Elite, they've got to say, solid strat in the last game. It was very... well, basically, secure strap. The picks were very safe. Very hard heroes to kill off. Dustbin's heroes relied a lot. Well, the draft relied a lot on that OD getting really big. And he knew he had to as well. It's the reason why he was trying to rush up that sheepstick on the Obsidian Destroyer. And it just didn't work in the end. It was just one of those things where all the other lanes didn't work. They did have that problem as well where the SK skill didn't skill Burrow Strike at the first point. And the remake was disallowed, so it was basically he was walking around with +2 stats, and they didn't have the Burrow Strike initiation. But yeah, that wasn't the real problem. There was a couple of other little chinks in the Dustbin armor that they've got to try and look for and see if they can try and get it fixed very shortly. They're going to have to right now as we go through our next draft and we see no first pick SK. But it's going to be Windrunner Quap as well as SK being removed out by WE. Lycan as well as Darkseid being removed out by Dustbin, and the Invoker removed out as well, which means our first pick will be Prophet to WE, more than likely. And they don't. They say, you know what, screw it, we're going to take the Brew. We're going to take the Brewmaster. We think his stayability is more important than anything else in the world, which means Dustbin do get the Prophets. They get a little bit of global control, which they're going to need, but then again, Prophets can become food for Brewmaster if he gets any decent amount of farm. And we see a fast Blink deck like we did on the Brewmaster in the last game. Standing up against that's gonna be very difficult. Prophet won't be able to get out, won't be able to get away easy enough. The TP time is actually, I think, a little bit longer than the Brewmaster ulti has to come out and then throw the stun. 5 seconds. So it'll probably depend on the distance between the Brewlings as well as where Prophet's TPing. So Dustbin have two picks. And they'll be looking more than likely to go with the Prophet. I don't know if they go push, and they'll take the Morphling as well. Radiant team pick. So they're going to get to have a lot of farm up on that Morphling, because Prophet's going to make sure of that. Well, we assume so. Prophet could also be up there in that top lane, and not in the jungle. I always like a jungle Prophet, mainly because he's able to TP out and join a lane without having to leave a lane and leave another hero farming. Well, I like Jungle Prophet, but he's also great in the top lane. To start pulling with those trees. There's the chain out from WE, so a very similar lineup to last time. Two of the heroes they used last time.
5 seconds remaining.
Trying to work out if they can go the exact same draft, and yeah, they can if they want to. Apart from the fact that it is Morphling. But that can easily be replaced by yet another hero. The Morphling was great, but there's still anti-mage that can be picked up. And they might think about that line too, but maybe not, considering they've already got the Brewmaster. They want to get themselves some kind of range damage hero, as opposed to the Brewmaster, who had to come in close. And they're going to take the Lone Druid instead. So we've got huge amounts of life points on WE again. So Dustbin need right-click damage. Morphling gets to it to a point, but all three heroes now for WE, they can't be shotgunned down. It's going to be like a right-click. It's going to be like a Manta-style Morphling, which has to be built by Dustbin if they're going to try and deal with the amount of life points on WE. And we got one more hero to pick up right now, and they've got to find themselves a damage dealer. But I don't know if they should pick him up right now. WE is going to ban him out just like they did last time. They'll take out all the damage dealers. They removed out Void and AM in the last part of the last game.
Reserve time.
But this time around, what does Dustbin want to do? They're eating into their extra time about this. They're probably trying to toss up right now. Do we run the Morphling in the middle lane and then take an anti-mage bottom lane and just try and live through them that way? And just say, you know what, late game, we've got this out carried. Or do we try and find ourselves a big mid-game damager? Because Morphling can be semi that, but only semi. Against these three heroes, it's only semi. Shaker the pickup by Dustbin. So lane control in the bottom lane. They'll run the safe try lane. I doubt they're going to try and control the top. But WE, they probably know more than likely that Lycan's going to, that Silibear's going to be on the bottom lane. So the lone druid puts Chen inside the jungle. Brewmaster, he could also go middle lane and then just leave one hero top solo and Crystal Bane to roam. But Crystal Bane being overlooked in the last game. I still don't understand that. She's such a fantastic support hero. Enigma being banned out by WE, so they're fearing a jungle. They're fearing a jungle or a deny lane. I'm probably not fearing it, but It kind of screws with their control. They wouldn't be able to move out freely. They don't want to have things that go through the BKB. Shadow Shaman again being banned out by Dustbin. Is there anyone that can stun Hex or push really fast? WE's already got that. They've got Chen as well as a lone Druid. As far as push power goes, with just those two heroes, you can push by yourself. Lone Druid can actually push by himself. Just Chen can give him his creeps. When WE, they look over at Dustbin, and Dustbin left their lineup pretty open. They can do whatever they really want to. So WE banning right now. They're just removing any hero, which would be a pain in the ass. They might ban out the Enchantress as the last one. Just in case Dustbin decide to try and run that jungler again. This Enchantress Urshay can help them really gank up that middle lane. And if Brewmaster's in there, which I kind of assume he will be, then they're in trouble. But they're going to ban out the Crystal Maiden instead. Dire team ban. So I think CMES was the combo that Dustbin were going for. Not 100% sure it would be. But hey, Data Pros, man. Data Pros. But last ban from Dustbin. I can't ban out the supports. The only thing they could try and ban out is like a ranged damage hero, and there's always going to be someone else for that. So they'd ban out the Tidehunter instead. Okay, is someone going Broodmother? Is someone going Broodmother on Dustbin? I think so. WE might be trying to pick him up in the last, but actually they could. They could take him up in the last one, throw Brood down towards that bottom lane. Even with the ES Fissure, the Broodmother has enough movement speed to run away if inside the web. So that's an option for him. But it might also be ES for Dustbin just babysitting that bottom lane, or WE run the Brood up on the top lane. Lone Druid can even, well, he can jungle, but they won't do that. But he can go to that bottom lane, safe lane, Brewmaster in towards the mid, then Chen. And then just one more. That's a lot of melee, though. That's a lot of melee. Gonna go three melee up against Dustbin, and you got a Morphling with range. It's like, oh, I want to get in close. I can't do that. But as far as lane control and map control goes, WE would have the whole shebang. The pushing power would be nothing they can deal with. And hello, pushing power. Lestrak into the last set again. But Lestrak support, and they got one more hero to run with. But this is just tower busters. This is just tower busters. That's exactly what WE have picked right now. Kill off the towers, they get the initiation from the Brewmaster. He jumps in, splits the ulti. And then any burst damage which Dustbin have thought about doing is just cancelled. They need that silence, they need that counter push. And they can't counter push against WE with a Broodmother, even though it is available. Brewmaster is just able to stomp all the spiderlings down. Lone Druid will get the Radiance up pretty early as well. And that's going to completely negate the effects of the Broodmother. The only thing it's going to help Dustbin do is win their lanes early on. And that might give enough space for Morphling to do what he needs to do. Hopefully also, I was told that my microphone was a little bit screwy in the last game. Hopefully it's a little bit better for the guys on Dota TV. Jakiro comes up. It's ballsy, I'll give it that. It's not a push down towers either. It's a counter pusher. But if you're going to do that, you could already run with like a DK or someone like that. But they want to use Jakiro. Are they out of support heroes?
10 seconds nope. Remaining.
There's still tons of support heroes. They could go Dazzle. There's even Witch Doctors. There's a Shadow Demon, which is now picked up. So there goes Morphling. The bigger he gets, the bigger it's turned around. We saw it the other night. When I believe it was Quantic versus VP. I'm now bringing my grid up on my side so I can remind myself about it. Well, it was VP versus Z-Nation, VP. I'm pretty sure it's Quantic versus VP. VP versus Mouse. No, it wasn't that. It was one of the games. But it was Kurakai playing as a Shadow Demon. And he just grabbed the Morphling, disrupted him, and then turned him around on your support heroes. But the Jakiro pick, I'm interested to know how this is going to fit in. It's a nice stun, it's a decent line ulti. And that can counter push a lot. And it's great for pushing down towers as well, because you've still got that the ability which they goos up the towers, so they attack a lot slower. So if they want to dive back past the towers, they can do that, but their lineup's not really built for that. And the amount of damage that will be done by the ultimate of Jakiro, unless he gets up in the levels, it won't be enough. Not up against WE. And if anyone's low, then you just disrupt them for a moment, and the ult will be worn off by the time he comes out. 10 seconds remain. Razor. And Razor is the last pick up from Tuspin. Okay. Maybe we're slowly going to work out what the hell is going to go on right now, but this is... Okay, Tuspin. Got a whole bunch of melee boys, so what are you trying to do? You pick up the plate mail, man. The man basically built out of the plate mail. But that's gonna be the lineup for Tuspin. Prophet, Morphling, ES, Jakiro, as well as the Razor. So they got great counter push, in fact. In fact, they got amazing counter push when it comes to destroying creep waves really, really fast. But when it comes to fighting up against WE, Not as good. That's going to have to come from the Morphling. And if Morphling is able to get to that point, then Shadow Demon's just going to replicate, just disrupt him up and pull him out of the engagement. I mean, I want to know how Dustman execute this. I really want to see how they're going to execute this. Because they have got to get this perfect. And they've got to be aggressive as well. Like, I'm even talking like bot lane aggressive. Take that Razor. Take Jakiro. Take ES. Try and stick it to the man down there on the bottom lane. As we just have ourselves a quick pause. The guy's just asking if it spiked. I was fine. I don't know what happens when people say, oh, it spiked. No, it's just them waiting. Waiting to kick off into the game. Really didn't know how that Jakiro is going to work. Fenty's going to take up the Brewmaster this time around. Well, we got... Is it rather amusing that we got Chen? Or Chan? Is it Chan? It's Chan? Chan on the Lashrak. Icy. Onto the Shadow Demon. Luo is onto the Chen. And then GG will take up the role as the Lone Druid. Over to Dustbin. Ninja Boogie's going to take the role as the Nature's Prophet. So a more active Nature's Prophet. He went solo mid last time. I don't know if he's going to take the Prophet there this time around. But I'm actually kind of hoping so. Morphling can stop on that top lane. Arjun will be taking that role. Or throw him out on the bottom lane. But blah. Such a great hero when Razor with the changes to Static Link. Just the duration of it. It's just so ridiculous. So the Link duration is 8 seconds. The bonus duration is 18 seconds. So you got 8 seconds of pulling the damage in. And then you got 18 seconds of holding it. And you can drain out 28. Prepare for battle. 28 damage per second. It's like getting yourself... It's almost a Divine Rapier damage. For just a couple of moments. A couple of moments being about 20 seconds. It's ridiculous the amount of damage you can do with the Razor. And there's the ES Razor. And yeah, they're going to go aggressive bot. Oh, I like your Scepter, Prophet. He's got one of the cool Scepters. One Pimp My Prophet. Top lane is actually going to be Jewel. So we're going to see Jewel lanes. ES is going to babysit the Razor on the bottom lane here by Dustbin. Which is going to leave Prophet to solo up the mid. And then Morphling and Jakiro to go top lane. So good range of Rass. And Brewmaster's up here on the top lane. He's not going to be the throwaway lane. He's going to be up there as Jewel, with the Jewel lane as well. So Shadow Demon's up here. He's going to throw a ward down to make sure he can keep tabs on any movement up towards that top lane. Well, it's just anything happening. Scylla Bear is just scouting around. Just the bear, not Scylla himself. And War's also coming down from Nature's Prophet. So blocking these camps. Just want to restrict Chen's movements. Really good wards as well. Begins. Block camp, and block camp. So the three major camps are gone. Well, they'll be the ones that Chen would want to use. But he won't be able to in this game. The only camps he'll have is like the bigger creeps is this one here. And then he can farm this one. And he can jump back and forth between these two for maybe 3 minutes. But he'll need to rotate off to the side pretty early. So make sure that those wards are in the right spot and block the camps. So we go down towards the bottom lane. I wish you all the best of luck, Lashrak. You're going to need it in that lane. Razor is a pain in the ass to lane against. And, the ward didn't block it. It sees it, but it doesn't block it. Machan just being stalked by the Earthshaker. And Earthshaker just showing himself through the trees. like, you know I'm here, man. I want to force you back. And he can do so pretty easily. Ninja Boogie going up against a mid-druid. And then that top lane. Morphling, really scared to come in close. He knows that disruption will just pull him back out, and Brewmaster can go for the stomp. And that amount of damage is decent. Forces the wave out as well. He's only got one more of those. The amount of mana which was spent before. Hello, bottom lane. Robert's going to TP down. Nice little gank off, and Chan gets himself out of there. He needs to stun out and blind with the lightning damage. It's not enough. Maybe with the tower. Yeah, it is. Oh! Nuri is going to go down. Urcha gets the kill, but Ninja Boogie rotates for that one. So his first blood, but it's also space for Lone Druid to farm up in the middle lane. And great play there by Lashrak. Realized she was going down, skilled up the lightning. Now the one point in Split Earth, and while the damage was being taken by Razor, he had one of the other guys from Dustbin to try and take the aggro from the tower during that period. But they didn't in the end. It ends up being a trade. Razor has come back down towards the bottom lane, and Earthshaker with the first blood. Hopefully we'll put it to good use. Double damage for Ninja Boogie. He's going to TP up towards the top lane. Taking a look at Fanti, or are they? Did he? Where did he go to? He went down towards the bottom lane. I'm sure I saw a TP go towards the top, and they pick off the little Shrek again. Cop a decent chunk of damage for it, but still, that's another kill towards the bottom lane. And the experience goes all the way of Dustbin. You got to remember, Lashrak died before the kill happened on the Razor on the bottom lane. Which means, as far as experience advantage goes, it should be a lot higher for the Dire side. It must be this middle lane. What is this experience he's looking at? Yeah, 230. He's just cranking it up. 229 on the Lone Druid. 202 on the Brewmaster. Even 191 on the Lashrak. Jakiro is getting absolutely nada. And now Prophet going to TP towards the top lane. They want all this global gankage. And nice stun. Magical stun out there from Jakiro. Ensuring the kill on Shadow Demon. And the Prophet Sprout trying to do what it can. Still having some tangos left, Brewmaster gets himself out safely.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
But this is Dustbin being active on the map, and this is the power of Prophet. Dual lanes turn into dry lanes. But still, he's leaving this middle lane alone. And this means farm for our Lone Druid. And Lone Druid at this point is actually not even caring about getting really any items up. He's just slowly, bit by bit, getting more and more farm. Meanwhile, on bottom lane, here we go again. Fissure, the static link's already gone, so Lashrak has no right click damage. He still has his spells, and that's more powerful. And they go in on the towers. Razor comes in. Nice little stun. It's going to buy time for Shadow Demon, putting up the Soul Catcher on Nature's Prophet. Stun, though, and he's going to go down, disrupting himself on the last right click in from Razor. They can't take the damage up. Boogie get himself back. Almost dying, and the Razor blast is not enough. The Plasma Field and the extra TPs. They got a chance for three kills here. Chen needs one last right click, set a blast, is not in range. There's the right click. So Boogie will go down, now they focus on the Earthshaker. Razor already took a fall, back on the side. So the double kill for the Chen. And Dustbin overextend, throw away all their hard work, all their hard ganking. And give some freebies over to WE by diving past the tower. Bad. Copying a little bit too much damage there in the mid lane, especially considering Lone Druid just recreated him. He won't want that bear to take that much damage. Meanwhile, on the top lane, kind of forget about this Morphling for Dustbin. In fact, he's only level 4 is a large concern. Mid lane rotation. That's just Chen and Mia to move through the jungle. And almost getting Arcane Boost, so he'll walk himself up towards this top little shop. Get that energy booster. And then probably rotate up towards that top tier 1, try and get a gank up on the Morphling. Which they have to do sometime soon. Lashrak's been having a hard time on bottom lane, but Morphling up on that top lane. He's only got 21 for 7. Scylla's looking so great for his farm. There's Chen's illusions. Setting him off, and probably just going to make Ninja Boogie think twice about that middle lane. Finding him pick up his arcanes. But Boogie's got to be really... Well, actually, he's going to go bot lane in a moment. I realise how far Lautrec is up. So Earthshaker will come through with a fissure. Lautrec instantly going west, so Prophet will cancel the TP. And he also goes off to the side. Sprout holding them together. He's going to pop off just one level in Edict. He's got one extra split earth as well. Trying to run away, but there'll be another fissure in a couple of moments. Time, 5, 4, and he's using the time to salve. So the fissure won't be able to kill. He's going to get in range of the tier 2 tower, and Silverbear's killing off the mid tower while they're hunting this kill. Killing Lautrec might not be worth this. In fact, I can guarantee you it is not worth it. 3 euros committed to getting that kill, while Lone Druid continues to farm up in the middle lane. Taking out towers, the money is thrown back. Shadow Demon having some fun here with the Morphling. Throwing out enough damage. Oh, the time for the waveform. We're just a little bit off. He's trying to bait out the Brewmaster Stomp. He's coming back in again with that Haste Rune. Popping off the ball charge, getting his life back up again. Forcing them back from the tier 1 tower. Waving up and going to kill off the Shadow Demon, who disrupts himself. The Stomp to go off from Fenty again. But Azir's not finished just yet. Or maybe he is. Bottom lane. The hunt's on. Scylla. Sends his pair up the wrong way in the end, and the fissure from Lee is enough. Nice stun again. Chikiro, no extra ultimate, and blah. Gonna try and take the damage out from Lautrec. Lautrec's about to die though. Ninja Boogie, wonderful little trap there on the Lone Druid, just slowing him down. So now they'll have time to right click on that Lone Druid. How much damage was stolen? It was, well, 35 damage, or 55 damage. And the right click damage is enough. Razor kills off the Lone Druid. Big kill to get to Lone Druid. It's been a while since he, actually it's the first death for him. Hasn't been ganked anywhere else. He's been farming up and doing nothing but. Dustman will now push out the tier 1 tower in the bottom lane.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
There goes the tier 1.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
In the meantime, Brewmaster still stands on that top lane up against the Morphling. 23 for 5 up against the Morphling, who's 29 for 6. So this is holding his own in the CS. Oh, Lautrec, he's trying to block the creep wave up. If he only knew the stuns which awaited him. He's out too far. Fissure will go. Lautrec's out of position. Fissure still waiting for the right position, and there we go, we got it. Earthshaker gets the last hit in. That totem blast. In the meantime, Morphling dies on the top lane. Chen, he actually soloed that Morphling. Morphling must have been pretty low. Shadow Demon was able to steal that DD rune, but he's got bigger problems than just rune control. That bottom lane is still having a crack. There's actually only one hero left. It's just Shakiro. Scylla converting himself up into his lone druid form. Kind of knew that he needed that sometime soon. That extra tank ability makes it very, very difficult to bring him down. Middle lane set up. Fish has already popped off. Sprout as well. Icy. He's got his disruption if he needs it. He's thinking about it, but Earthshaker getting the block. Treant's also getting in front of him. He disrupts on somebody else, and now he's completely blocked in. Really wonderful positioning there by FTD. By the trees as well as the ES. And now Dustbin can push on the tier 1 tower in the mid. Getting a lot more control than what WE is able to achieve. But WE's pushing power comes in about 10 minutes time. Dustbin need to make him hurt right now. Stun goes out on Blah, but he also gets handed back there by Jakiro. Gets nuked down by Chen. 3 levels up on that test of faith. Razor gonna let off one last blast. Prophet. Sad has already done his damage. Prophet Aldi's gonna... Oh, hand of God. He'd need to pop that off a couple of seconds earlier just to be safe, but still he had enough life to live through it. And down the bottom lane. And Druid looking to push out against Prophet.
Top tower.
How far off the relic are we now? Or is he gone? He just ended up going phase boots on himself.
Top
tier 1 tower is taken. Lone Druid TP to defend, but there's nothing more to defend. There's a lot more space to farm though. Chen with his couple of kills he's got really helped rush up that mech. Not completely done just yet, but give him some time. Buckler as well as headdress. So all these extra kills he's been managing to find. That double kill on the bottom lane, that one kill in the mid. this easier for him. And looks like Ninja's Prophet. Surprisingly too, he's not going mech for his team. Not to keep him alive or anything like that. He's gone Aghanim Scepter. At least point booster to start with. See if he goes in the Aghanim Scepter after that. Jakiro going to look for the stun. It's on the right line and he baits the animation. Just forcing WE to fall back a little bit. But the bear goes towards the front lines. They all start going on the tower. I'll have to stun him if they want to stop this. There's a Shadow Demon. Wave up over the top. Gives him some vision. The bear is getting stunned off. And Fanti towards the front line. He's still got ultimate, so he doesn't really care too much. If he cops damage, then he'll shrug it off. And we see Chan now in the middle lane, playing his little track. Getting some free time to farm up, and Razor just follows him everywhere he goes. Prophet Ultimate will bounce, and he'll TP as well. Sprout to go. And there goes that surge. Just so much damage so fast. Rune Master wanting to come here in towards the middle lane. Letting off just a couple of illusions of himself to start with. And the real one comes in. The Fissure flies through them all anyway. Chen's also on the move back. Wow, Jakiro's popped ulti. I suppose it's only a 1 minute cooldown, but the bigger problem for him is the amount of mana it costs. I suppose do it if it pushes back out the lane and causes trouble for Chen. Morphling continues to farm up here on the top lane. Well, for 12 minutes, he might have a little bit more than Treads and Ring. And Magic Quantum Bottle, okay, he's got enough. What's his farm and deaths? So yeah, one death to his name. That's the reason why he's just a little bit further behind than what I thought he would be. Once again, we're seeing Brewmaster rushing at that Blink Dagger. He had it by this point last game, but last game they were taking out some towers. They're actually sticking it to Dustbin. And it wasn't 6 to 10. Dustbin have done a really, really good job to try and get themselves back into this. As Nature's Prophet runs away. And very, very wisely too. Shadow Demon just in the neighborhood. One disruption, he'll never get out of there. And towards the middle lane, we already have one TP to the tier 2 tower. And Shadow Demon's also here. Fissure blocking out their pass so they cannot chase it. And the Ice Wall going down the same line. A lot of mana being used by Jakiro, which doesn't need to be. Oh, that's the reason why. He's got Arcane Boots. He doesn't give two hoots. His mana pool is so big now, he may as well just spam out all his abilities. Not going for that Liquid Fire. We might at least get 1 point in that for the towers. And the problem is if he does pop it off, also slows down the enemy's creep wave. That means his creep wave pushed that a little bit faster. Bottom lane gank about to happen. Prophet's already on the way out. Yes, however, has nothing to get out of there with. He'll walk. It'll be a long way to go down there for WE. A lot of wasted time. And they can't really waste any time. Dustbin controlling a lot of the map. And as you can see, we've already got almost 3k gold in favor of Dustbin. And 1,000 experience going up and down a little bit. It's going to go up and down a lot more now. Brewmaster with Blink Dagger. So initiation time now hits for WE. This is when they want to fight. So take the Lashrak, take the Shadow Demon. Take the Chen. And go and find some fights. Lone Druid, he can now buy up his Relic. And then go into the Radiance. So he wants to get it from the Dyer's shop. Actually, no, he must have the bear over there. The Relic now up on that bear, deciding to attack on the tower. Especially with the Chen creeps there in tow. It's going to be a very difficult, very, very difficult push to stop. Razor wants to though. Plasma Field to go out. A lot of damage already been done to Chen. He needs to get the Hand of God off right now. He will do so. Trying to get himself away, and Lone Druid locks him in place. Frost comes down from Jakiro. Spin up in towards the air as well. Brewmaster already popped off the Ultimate. Trying to keep Morphling out of this place so they can kill off Razor at the back end. There goes the Sun as well. It might be a little bit too much. Tower takes a fall during the meantime. Chen's putting off the stomp. Jakiro still keeping that ulti. That was a lot of burn damage and great Fissure. They're going to get the kill on Shadow Demon and maybe even Lone Druid. Yeah, they will. Lone Druid takes a fall as well. Tower kill or not. Fanti needs to get out. Blink Dagger. Blink Dagger. He cannot be attacked. There goes the Blink. Has to run back up through the trees and they spot him. Morphling waves down that Fissure just on maximum range. Triple kill for the Morphling. An amazing find for Dustin. Really showing that when it comes to team fights, maybe they've got what it takes. Able to move through all of the tankability of WE and the Brewmaster Ultimate and just keep spamming their abilities out. Maybe that was WE just thinking less of Dustin's team fight. Said, you know what, maybe we can just deal with that. But they could not. Now they will also claim up Roshan. Agon Imceptor is up on Ninja Boogie. We got Ogre Axe and Morphling. We'll probably take the Aegis at this point. Oh, yeah, give it to Morphling or Razor. Razor got the slot. He's coming in now. Fissure just looking to hold off that one little creep. And he'll come in. Say, like, oh, what you doing? Oh. Razor, yeah, he takes the Aegis Immortal using that one last slot. Which means Mithril Hammer can now be purchased up by Morphling. He'll get towards that BKB. And then WE going to find themselves in a lot more trouble. That Morphling is going to be too big for them to bring down. And they can't stun, they can't disable him. Even though the Entangle Roots will go through BKB. It's the only thing that WE have, and that's a percentage thing. They can't focus that. Right side though, that Radiance will be completed in a couple of moments for the WE fans. The Dustbin, they're going to be ready for it as well. They took one fight in the bottom lane, and that's going to already give them a large advantage in experience as well as gold. But they've got to remember what a lone druid could do with a Radiance. Pushing on multiple lanes. It's very, very difficult to stand against that, but then again, they have a profit. It's probably the reason why he's got Agon Imceptor. How do you deal with it with a hero that can push any lane he wants to without even standing in the lane? Get an Agon Imceptor. Crank that Prophet ulti. Hopefully in the meantime. Where's that BKB? He must have spent the money on the Mithril Hammer already. Yeah, it's sitting on the courier. I was wondering what's taking so long. Frost. Nice little juke of it. Razor wants to come up. The Fissure. It's going to go on the bear. They can't kill it off. And almost... Oh, no! No! He's blocked in Razor. Proton will go in. Tangle Roots will go as well. Blar was locked in place by Lee. He's going to do what he can to hold him in, to keep him alive. Oh, that could have been disastrous. In the meantime, though, Prophet TP's bottom lane. And we'll push the tier 2. He's always going to bring it down. Siege Creep in tow. In fact, he's got this. The Tree and Lion will take care of the rest with the Siege Catapult. There's nothing more that Chan can do about it but try and go for the deny. He missed that one as well, so we're only one out of tower now left for WE. Dustbin tightening the noose around WE's neck. Jigiro's coming in, looking at Chen. And there goes the ulti with the Frost, trying to hold him in there. Echo Slam, but wonderful time for disruption. Echo Slam does no damage. Luo, does he have Hand of God? He does. He doesn't want to use it. He's going to have to use it, though. Mech charge to go, and wow, long dive in here by Razor. Aegis the Immortal is now thrown away. TP's going to be here. Disruption will go. No, he's short of mana. But he'll have Soul Catcher in a moment, which he does use, and it catches. So how much damage can you deal? Brewmaster still having that ulti. So he can blink and stomp, which he will do so. Blink, stomp, pop in the ultimate. Fissure's going to pop off as well by the Earthshaker, trying to buy some time. Earthshaker stun. The Brewling Stun, sorry, flying up there and killing off Razor. And Razor goes down. Lashrak with the last click in. Revenge is sweet. And Earthshaker's on the move, but the bear is on the run after him. Moving hard and fast through the lane. Is he close enough for a right click? Maybe getting entangled. There's the stomp. And the burn is just killing off the Earthshaker. Stun. Fissure. Still burning. The bear is going to be forced back, though. Right click damage out from Morphling is too high. That's a bit of a throwaway just there by Razor. Not only his life, but the Aegis, the Immortal as well. Now that Radiance is up on the Scylla Bear. Holding on himself and not his bear for the moment. Realize he was using his bear for aggression. To be careful not to lose it again. Morphling has returned towards the middle lane. I'm not thinking about killing him right now. It can only be a thought, though. I'm profit now with 3k gold. I'm wondering what he's going to go next. He could look at a sheep stick, but there's no big one hero that he has to take out. So maybe try and get... Well, is there a mech up? Please tell me there's a mech. Please get a mech. Buy a straight mech, will ya? Down the middle lane. Dustbin going to push on the tier 2 tower. Just where are these extra items? They just don't belong here. There's a gem up on Chen. Nowhere to hide. I'm not quite sure who for. Must just be dewarding in the end for Chen. Wanting to remove Dustbin's vision of their own base. Towards those front lines. Fanti's here as well, maybe thinking about a kill. Razor over resets himself again, then yeah, he'll go for it. The Razor will be a little bit more cautious. This is the reason why. And this is what the bear can do. Just stand on lane. He can't right click when he's that far away from his master, but he can still burn. So he stands next to jungle camps, creep waves, the whole thing pushes. And he gets a lot of experience from doing this as well. So we got a lone druid with everything on the back of the bear, and yeah. Heal up, go back out, do it all again. Smoke gank now by WE. I kind of want to go on that jungle. I know someone's here. They're just trying to hide around the other side of the trees. Now Fanti moves himself forward. Razor will show himself as well as Prophet. Will they catch out the support heroes in the jungle? That's what they want. There's Fanti, now revealed out. He got attacked, so he can't blink. Fissure splits WE in half. Jakiro will look for the stun. Goes through the middle of him, doesn't get anybody though. Urshak has already taken a fall. Now he's in trouble. Fanti's riding his tail. He's still got ultimate there, that Brewmaster. Hand of Gold will keep him alive as well as the mech. A lot of life coming back. Really nice stun by Jakiro. Buys just enough time to TP out the Morphling as well as the Razor. And then Ninja Boogie heads in towards the middle lane. So the support heroes go down for Dustbin. WE find themselves some kills, but they're going to lose control in their other lanes. On the bright side for WE, there's no towers to be brought down. So even though the control is lost, they won't lose any of their farm. They won't lose any of the advantage from it. But that advantage keeps going the way of Dustbin. Almost 10,000 gold advantage towards Dustbin. Thinking about 7.5k. What are we looking at? 3, 2, 3, 8, 5. So yeah, 6.5k. That's the experience difference. The Morphling's just getting so big. Looks like he's gonna go for Skadi. They're gonna try and get an entangled root. He's not lucky enough though. Morphling would have just strength morphed or waved or got out of there somehow. It's just like that. He's even got a replicate running around inside the jungle of WE. Possibly looking for that 24-minute room, which is an invis on the bottom lane. Yeah, they see the Morphling is there. They know it's not Prophet. Chen trying to make a move out as well. Himself a decent army. Double stun as well as a troll trap. It's good enough to kill anybody who's out of position. And now invis room for Morphling. Like, there's an army there, but then again, we have a gem up on Chen. Morphling is getting really overconfident for where he is. Chen's gonna come up, they can see him, they're trying to kill off Fanti. Does he have an ultimate? No, he does not, he's almost gonna die. Really, Prophet, Sprout, and Blink away, he does! Brewmaster gets out. There's a lot of abilities wasted to kill him off. Morphling kills off the Shadow Demon in the meantime. And now there's trouble for, Chen. Gem is on the ground, picked up by Jakiro. And they'll keep pushing down this middle lane. The bear is burning everything else, but everyone else is dying. Razor inside the base, trying to kill off Latrak, but Latrak having enough pulse and damage to do the job. And the bear being in tow. So Chen as well as SD down for Razor as well as ES. Gonna say that's actually better for WE. They got their big hero still up. And Brewmaster, I'm here in TPs. Latrak, got a lightning with level 4 to push him back. Earn's going out on Morphling. Trying to keep him up, and that bear going to look for an entangle. They want a straggler. Can they get one? Can they get one? One last right click. Adaptive strike. Azhin waves himself up a long way high. And blink up from Fanti. He's not close enough for the stomp, and he knows it. The Shrek is just too fast, and then the ES Fissure. The bear will still get to burn a little. So the end of that fight, even though it did look like Dustbin had the upper hand in it, just unable to kill off that Brewmaster meant that the fight was actually going the way of WE. I didn't see any buybacks during that last point. So just the fact it was 2 for 2 and the fact that Raid to die was the bigger thing. Prophet, really smart time to TP out. And this will be the reason why he had vision. Sorry, that's the Dire Ward. No, actually, it's just the game sense. So Chen goes back to create his army again. He lost it all. Wondering if we got Dustbin. Have they got mech up just yet? Well, still got Jakiro. Tell me he's got enough money for something. That gem, he took off Chen. And we got the Agnim Scepter and Sheepstick is going to be coming up for profit, so he's going to go for that. Either that or he's looking at Manta style. And both are actually possible. Pushing with the Manta Illusions, he becomes a right-click damage healer. He doesn't need to be while he got Razor and Morphling on the field. And Razor already walking around with Manta style of Vanguard. And Morphling with BKB and one ultimate orb on him. I think I said before, he's going Scardy. Hello, Roshan. He has returned. And there's the ping out from Shadow Demon. They know the timing is right here for Dustbin. They get another Aegis the Immortal up on that Morphling. Well, even Morphling, Razor, anybody. Razor's the one with the inventory slot. And they're going to be looking good. The Razor Illusion. Must be set an auto attack path. Oh, Roshan already down half life. WE are not defending this. Not going to try and stop them. At this point, they might have been able to as well. But they need the vision to do so, and they don't. Dire have the vision, know they're going to come in. And now they get the announcement. Dire has been killed, and Razor picks up the Aegis. He's got to deal with Razor twice over again. Look at that Spirit Bear. These items are coming up for the Lone Druid. Really fast as well. It's going to be an AC for him pretty soon. And Lashrak, not far off his Bloodstone. Maybe with a couple of charges, he'll give WE even more during those team fights. Fanti, Blink Dagger, Treads as well as a Bracer. He's still pretty raw, but he's just initiation. Aghanim Scepter, he would love. But, yeah. He doesn't have the farm. He can't find the farm. Shadow Demon can't find anything. Double Gauntlet. Like, well, I was thinking about getting an urn, and then I thought against it, because I have no money. Bottom lane. It's Razor, but it's not the real one. But Icy's still showing himself. And maybe a push coming on the Tier 2 tower. Bear on the front line, double Centaur, so yeah, why not? Prophet Alderman bounces, but doesn't bounce down towards that bottom lane. Arzian, thinking about pushing out that top lane. He's got support there from Prophet, so they might be able to. But the TPs will come back pretty fast from WE, so they just want one creep wave. Even the ulti flying out there from Jakiro demolishes the entire creep wave of the Radiant side. And that's going to forcibly come back to base. They're getting killed through their top tier 3. If they want to try and fight this right now, which they're going to, Jakiro will take a fall. The Morphling with the BKB, I don't think he will. Razor, he's just stolen their time, Hand of God. But look at the top lane, tier 3 tower. Fortifications actually still up their sleeve. TP came back. They want to go for the tier 2, but Prophet continues to fight in that top lane. They're hoping for an entangle route. Morphling jumps back to the Replicant, ripping now on Nature's Prophet, but Lone Druid is the one who's in trouble. He got hexed up, and they're going to kill him off. And this will be top racks, but look at the life of Ninja Boogie. They're stunned. The lightning bounces through. They get the kill. Prophet buys back. Lone Druid does take a fall. A Prophet for Lone Druid. Tier 2 tower remains in the bottom. And up on the top lane, Prophet, man, you might have just completely overextended yourself. Stuns up on the track, but the Rangers and Ryan Morphling jumps in a long, long way. But Shadow Demon is here. Disruption to start with. Trying to go on the Prophet. Stump to go as well. Nature's Prophet just died twice over. So expensive to try and get that Rax. Throwing money the way of WE or just throwing money out the window. It's like, who cares? We've got over 14k. We can claim a Rax. That's fantastic. was the money and who you give it to. It wasn't a lone druid. The lone druid is going to be happy for that. There's Bloodstone now full of Shrek, though. Mech is already done. And looks like we've got the pipe coming out from Chen. So we've got Chen going for both pipe as well as mech. I think I saw the start of a hood up on lone druid. It's only the start, though. And it's possible that's actually meant for lone druid, that ring. Nah, perseverance. Definitely meant for Lashrak. Yeah, he already disassembled his arcane boots. He put the ring over there. And picked himself up a cloak. His arcane boots were disassembled to make the soul booster. WE with that last engagement. There's that difference, which he just... That one time. Yeah, double kill down on profit. Yeah, kill down the bottom lane as well. Goal doesn't really change up that much because the tier 3 tower was lost on the top lane. There's the experience which counts the most to WE right now. Right now. Silbear gets his bear back in a moment. They have anywhere else on the map. Not pushing out anywhere. So yeah, it must be a recreation. Brings it back and gets all his auras. So notice how close he is towards that radiance. I mean, that AC. Already having the chainmail and the plate mail. Plate mail is up on himself right now. So all he needs is the recipe. And with this creep wave, if he gets it all, he's got it. He's managed to claim majority of it. Gets all bar one. But she's still being a little bit short. So I need just a little bit more than that. That would light the AC right now. Hang on. Prophet's going to TP in towards the middle lane. So that means they're not going to push out this top lane. Unless they try and go a four-man push strat. Lashrak, get yourself up there. Now Dustbin knows our 4v4, and they can go in for this one. Gonna go straight for the melee ranks. There's no fortification. Blink in already. Fanny trying to do his job. He's got ultimate, which he'll need to pop in a moment, but Morphling popping the BKB. He still tries to bring down that Rax. The pulse going out from Lashrak. They won the kill. I don't think they're gonna get it though, Lashrak. Almost going to get stunned up on the move up from with Jakira with his cold wall. Throwing out the ultimate, missing both right now. That's not going to help out. Lashrak forced back. Razor letting off the surge. The plasma field. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Prophet tries to push up against the lone druid, who has now completed up his AC. And he'll head up towards the top lane. Morphling waving himself away. Dustbin continues to try and attack. Stun going out in the Earthshaker, but the Brewmaster almost going to wear off, but Shakiro is going to go down first. Prophet has TP to draw in this fight as well. Shadow Demon really low life. Sprout going off, holding Lashrak in place. Then now Silabear moves himself over towards the Prophet. ES takes a fall as well. Double kill now for the lone druid, Morphling. Well, he's already on the sidelines. It's all coming down to Razor. He used the Aegis to come back up again. He gets himself another kill. Triple kill for the Razor, but the lone druid is still up. There's gems lying everywhere on the ground. He just wants one entangle root so he can bring down Razor. He's already got the aura burning through. He just needs one entangle root. And this will be the death of Razor. And he gets it on the first swipe. Blur is gone. The dominating streak is gone. It's an ultra kill for the lone druid. Four of them get to go the way of WE. They hold their racks as well. It was a little bit costly. And they gave a lot of money towards that Razor. But Razor just threw a lot of it back again. Lone Druid. A lot of moolah from that. 2300. He can finish up his own hood. That'll be just his personal hood. He's already got the aura for his team. Radiance as well as AC. That last fight was an absolute mess. It split off into multiple sections. I was like, hey, let's just try and focus one hero. No, he's up here. No, he's over there. Brewmaster, he's in three different freaking places at once. How am I supposed to deal with that? Wait, I can't. The fact that Jagiro also missed that big ultimate. It's only 60 seconds that I'm aware of, but... 60 seconds, that's a lot of extra damage at the very, very start, which changes the decisions that WE makes. Prophet ultimate bouncing around, and hello, he picks off Shadow Demon. Ninja Boogie with a swipe, and gets himself out safely. Realized he didn't have a lot of time as well, so he used his teleportation ability first. And then use his TP scroll to get himself back out. Hopefully in the meantime, Mana Style, BKB. Shaker with 4 staff. Didn't go Blink Dagger in the end. Let's go more the team item. Roshan's up in 2.5 minutes. And there's going to be a big fight for WE to take. They cannot let Roshan go down again. They have to push out and know what's going on around that pit. Because if Dustbane take Roshan, they get Nagus and the cheese, and this is over. They can push through and they will take that top racks. I don't know if they can completely GG it though. But it will be a lot to bring down WE and force a lot of buybacks. And it will be that little pitfall that just changes that end momentum. Which at this point, WE are trying to pull back 14k gold. And there's the experience jump, 6,000. Almost leveling it out. The gold will come with time once those tier 2 towers take a fall. But you gotta remember, Dustbin still have a 4 tower advantage. And the gold advantage is 12k. It's just the map control at this point. Which is where they get their money from, but Prophet just keeps pushing through. His CS must be pretty freaking high right now. 204, not as high as you'd think. Lone Druid is in fact the most farmed hero on the map. 267, 8 for 3. And the Prophet ulti bounces again. But thankfully for WE players, they weren't visible. So they will push out the middle lane for now, but bottom lane momentum. The track being down here. A quick lightning as well as a stun, and the trees are forced back. Again, Dustbin thinking about assaulting through the top lane. But again, WE will try and hold the line. And now we see a demon edge up on the Spirit Bear. He's going damage. Full ass damage on that bear. Once the MKB gives him faster attack speed, better damage as well. So a better chance to get that entangled root off. And a faster way to counter push the lane. Not to mention once he starts pushing towers. Lone Druid can do it by himself. He can actually push faster than the entire Dustbin side combined. Against buildings, that is. It's because of that bonus he gets through the bear, the demolish. And then the battle cry. Battle cry, demolish, anything he wants. Top lane. Blink up. Oh, Azian. Again, wrong position. Roshan's up. Is there again? WE, they got no vision for this. The lanes are still being pushed. Prophet Ultimate's making sure of that. This is not a Roshan they want to lose. Aegis and Cheese for Dustbin. WE are grouping up to smoke, but it might be a little bit too late. Roshan's already down at 2/3 of his life. 1/3 of his life. Now quarter, now nothing. They've got it. Aegis and Cheese. So Aegis goes to Razor. And Cheese will go to Morphling. He's going to drop the Ring of Aquila? No. Hold on to that one. He drops the bottle instead and gives it over to Jakiro. So he can just carry for him. Smoke up from Fandy heading up towards the top lane. With everybody else. But Dustbin third Roshan now. And that's going to tip that advantage back again. 4k was there, but Dustbin, they hold too much control. But they still cannot take a Rax, and that's their biggest problem right now. Bottom lane set up. And they're going to look for that tier 3 tower. They might be able to claim it as well. Surprising though, they're coming through the bottom lane to go through another tier 3 tower instead of going through the top lane. Well, it's a split push. There's 2 on the top, there's 3 on the bot. Trying to divide and conquer WE. Because there's the Morphling and the Prophet, and they can push really hard and really fast by themselves. So this bottom lane is not actually a push lane. This is a harassment lane. All they want to do is just add that pressure towards the bottom. They can push. But the top lane can push a lot faster. And that's going to force WE's attention. So they've got to deal with the top lane before they can deal with the bottom lane. They've still got fortification. They might be able to do so if they can find themselves a kill. Blinking right now. They want the Prophet. Prophet will TP. They need a Centaur stun. Disruption will do the job though. Follow up with the stun. They've got to bring down the Nature's Prophet. Razor has killed off Lashrak in the meantime. Prophet will take that fall and there's that big kill. But there's a buyback. Bottom lane. Lashrak, he also buys back. Wants to hold them off. Wonderful stun there by Jakiro. And a lot of damage being taken by Lashrak. He's locked in place with the Fissure. No, he's not. There's a small gap. Brewmaster pops the ultimate. Wants to force him out through that bottom lane, but meanwhile in the top lane, Boogie's up there. They cannot chase this. Earthshaker might be dead, but they've got to stop this Rax from going down. TPs are coming back. Shadow Demon is here. The Treant is what they're going to deal with. The burn might be enough. And they might get another kill on Prophet again. For a buyback double kill. Is there a root? Is there something? Yeah, there is. The Rax will live, but Morphling jumps in. He's right clicking and BKB. He's almost dead. He gets entangled. Oh! Dustbin. 133 on the Rax. The bottom one, the tower, is gone as well. But they still don't claim the Rax. And that's the important thing for WE. They hold the line again. And Dustbin are forced back. The strat was right, but WE's coordination was better. And the Aegis and... Well, the Aegis is still on Razor. But the cheese was used. It was not enough. And now WE make a beeline down the middle lane. They got control of their lanes back again and Prophet's down, so they're not going to be pushed on the side lanes. And the best time to push is now. Tier 2, Tier 3, but then fall back. They might think about taking the Rax, but they're going to be careful about overcommitment. Because if they do overcommit... Yeah, look at Razor already down the bottom lane. He can take that bottom Rax by himself. It's going to force the TPs back. And do they have TPs? Lashrak does. Lone Druid does. Everyone does. And there we go. They take the Tier 2. The Bear on the bottom lane actually cancels off the creep wave. They only take the Tier 2 and then retreat. Look at that MKB up on the Bear. He's just tanking that creep wave so badly. Then Lone Druid knows he can create a new one in just a couple of moments' time. So how's our advantage looking now? There's still about 12k in the red, but experience-wise, zilch. Zippo, nada. WE have managed to bring it back at 25-23. They take the kill lead. Only by two. 42 minutes in. That's still a precarious position for them. They've got to know that Prophet can push fast, and he's wanting to as well. Demon Edge. He can't buy a bank, so he may as well spend his cash. He'll just keep popping that ulti, keep those lanes pushed. Actually, he holds it for the moment. It's always a bad idea too, but... I suppose, considering WE will always just farm the lanes anyway. This Bear is giving momentum towards the top lane. If they can kill this Bear, that's actually going to be the biggest thing for them. And there's a Fissure in. They've got to keep right-clicking on that Bear, though, or else he'll just pull it back. And now down towards the bottom lane. Smoke gank? Yep. And the pause from Prophet. He needs a moment. Not quite sure exactly what the moment is for, but did we lose anybody? Let's see anybody DC'd. Maybe they're going to pay their money again to hold onto their seats at the LAN cafe. That's happened before. But for now, it's just it's like where do you try and look to go? Dustbin just they've got two tier 3 towers down and a top Rax which is sitting at 500 life points. That's what they want. That's what they desperately want. If they can achieve it, though, I don't think they can right now. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, the cafe's got a technical problem. So hopefully they'll sort it out in just a couple of moments. But this is just that moment as well where you just got to go. WE, have you just managed to pull back a 14k gold deficit and maybe even be able to win it while still being 12k behind? Zero exactly. Well, not exactly. It's a difference of 20 experience. You go 43 minutes and 45 seconds in with everything which has happened, and there is only 20 experience separating these two teams. That is all. What do we got for items too? I noticed that Ghost Scepter up on Lone Druid. There's a lot more up on his Bear, so don't get... Yeah, there's a lot more on the Bear. But it's that Ghost Scepter, and that's going to screw with Morphling if he wants to try and right-click down the Lone Druid. Shadow Demon's walking around with an urn. Looks like he's building towards a four staff. Blink Dagger on Brewmaster and Ultimate Orb as well. So it's not towards an Aghanim Scepter, it's just towards something else. Going to watch Morphling die in the bottom lane in a couple of moments. Oh, there's the reveal. And the stomp's going to happen. He jumps to Replicate. How do you kill him? You cannot. All he wanted to do was split push. That's why the Replicate was up on the top lane. And in the meantime, trees push out the middle lane. Roshan up in 4 minutes. So maybe Dustbin will try and go again then. And WE, I'm going to say it again, man. Don't give him a... It's going to be a fifth Roshan. Or is it a fourth Roshan now? It'll be a fourth Roshan the Dustbin will take. They won't want to let that happen. They're going to push out their lanes to start with. And I think this is what's going to be coming down. Oh, Morphling! He's jumping in. He's going to try and snipe the racks. The bear's going to get up there. He's going to take it. BKB to help him out. Wave out to safety. But will he get out with his life? If he goes down right now, oh, someone's got a four staff. And the bear towards the front lines. They want to make him pay. And now look through the bottom lane. Dustbin. It's a surgical attack. Slicing and dicing. The top race going down now means WE have got a thorn in their side, that top lane. And Razor, they want to find one of the big kills. But Razor has AC. Vanguard and Manta. And he's difficult enough to bring down. Oh, wow, really, Jakiro? It's not a big kill, but it's at least one of them. And now he's got 50 seconds on the sideline, no buyback. And actually, no, he can. But it cost him all his moolah. It's a small amount of time. And it's just one less support here for Dustbin. But he's not the critical one. Critical one is his Prophet. He pops the ulti to keep the lanes pushed. Silhouette keeps pounding away at that middle lane. They got to get back up towards that top. Prophet just needs to pop that ultimate whenever it's off cooldown. That top lane will continue to be a thorn in their side. And look at coming in. Going to go on the range racks. Got the Mega Melee creeps. 814 life to the 610. 27 damage to 52. It's too big for the normal creep wave to deal with. The only upside is it's not also the range creep stacking. Because when that kind of stuff happens, then you start losing towers. As they start attacking, they really do a lot of damage really fast. The melee creeps just gain the momentum. Shaker four staffs himself away. And very, very wisely done so. Illusion. And Prophet's back down the bottom lane. It's just a split pushing. Morphling finally completes his next item. The Eye of Skadi is now done for him. Ah, is he looking for a kill? There's one dire ward there. They got a ward further up, seeing. I think they caught a glimpse of it. Yep, here we go. Brewmaster can see the Earthshaker. They want the kill on the bottom lane. Now he's going to turn around, but hello, a little bit more than what they bargained for. Fissure, Earthshaker blinks in with the Echo Slam. Well, four stars. Actually, you know, it was a blink into the Echo. Disruption buys a little bit of time, but Brewmaster's already gone down with Ultimate intact, and that's not the best thing for them. Frost going out on Chen. Troublesome now. Fight for WE. Waveform in, and Morphling has now joined the fight. Fight back by Lestrak. Razor will take a fall while Lone Druid tries to fight. He's getting stunned up. Jakiro returns at the right time. Ghostep tries to buy himself some time. Ninja Boogie getting done. Bear will be recreated. If Lone Druid dies now, it's going to be big for them. Even after buyback, he won't have that bear again. He turns. He gets killed. Shadow Demon will go down. And this is going to be GG. Lone Druid buys back, but as I said, he has no bear now. He's lost all of his auras. There is nothing he can do. Brewmaster will live, and maybe he can saw them off. Prophet buys the MKB and will TP in a second. We'll pop the ulti as well to give a little bit more momentum towards all lanes. And they're going to go for the melee racks. The Lone Druid, he's another minute and a half before he's got his bear back. So he's just basically a cannon fodder. He will go down. Ghostet will buy him some time. Brewmaster blinks in, but he's turned into a chicken before he can do anything. This is GG. We're going to go to a third. The really sad thing is, I don't know if we're going to have time to go to a third. We actually won't. Because we've got our... Oh, man. We might miss the first game of Z Nation versus MTW. We're going to stick with this. We're going to stick with this and see if Dustbin or WE get through. The third game going to come up in a moment, but Dustbin have fought back. WE have already called the GG. Dustbin will take it in the 49th minute. Just those moments getting picked off. WE wanting to fight from outside their base. And not taking the patient approach. And there's the throne explosion. Dustbin's going to be really, really happy with that. By picking off this win now, they keep themselves in the running for the international. They must win this game if they want to advance forward, though. Without this game win, they will not have a chance at the concession final, because the winner of this will face up against the loser of Tongfu versus Aeon. The winner of that then plays for a spot to travel all the way to Seattle to compete at the International for the $1 million prize pool. Who will it be? You'll find out in a moment. Do not go anywhere.